And I guess after we put the last thing in, like probably, yeah, the last thing, we will go down, I guess.
I wouldn't try jumping if I were you. He couldn't control everything after all. I remember when this bridge collapsed not long before you came. It's a relief to see how time and nature together could outplay even him. How an unforeseen accident can ruin a life's work. I can't deny that his failure brings me joy. Unfortunately, I still need you to stay on his path. I think I may be able to guide you through.
Oh.
But first, I need to show you something.
Okay.
Follow me. You will not fall.
Really? I hope not. Wow.
Don't look down.
Yeah, good idea. No, I will. I just will.
Just follow me.
I'm flying!
Trust me.
I'm trusting her.
No need to hurry.
I have no idea
you
what to think about this.
Trust me.
She will definitely not kill me.
This path leads to our sanctuary.
She trusts me.
He removes
so
the crystals to
we'll just take
dolls.
It and go.
Let's have some light. I suppose he wanted to hide this place from you.
Oh, so he actually
it's
also
not far
saw
from
this.
Here.
All right. Okay. So we need the key to get there.
I brought him here once too. Surprisingly, it is one of the only places he didn't ruin since then. But I doubt he kept it intact simply out of respect.
Hmm. I will take this, if you don't mind.
This is the place we once called the Great Hall of the Amajat, the Shrine of the Seekers. You must look around and bind some blue crystal powder to cast into the fire.
I already picked a blue crystal. But I need a powder. So maybe I will go up and like break it there. Maybe. There is a key.
Have you found any blue crystal powder yet?
Oh, so I actually really, really need a powder first. So, let me just go back because I saw at the beginning there was a closed door over there. Actually, I can go also up here.
We need blue crystal powder.
Shut up! I'm on it! Don't worry. Alright, so let's open this. Wow. You should call someone to take a look at your locks and doors because they are rusted. Oh, I see what you need to do. So now I will take the powder, I will place it here, or the crystals, and then I will just do, I will mash it with the, like in the mortar. I hope one mash is enough. And Okay, I need more. Actually, do I need more? Yeah, I need to mash it more. Smash it more! The classic three. It still looks fairly intact. Okay, let's just go there and let's take a look if it changed at all. No. Oh, I see. So I need to put the pot over there and then smash it. And it will hopefully go in after a few smashes. No? Oh, I see. So I need to put it after it goes because it will grind it a little bit. All right, got it.
Good. Now use the crane up there to throw the powder into the fire.
Okay. Is it a good idea to throw something into the fire? If it will explode... Hold on a second. I hope it will not explode. Because... Oh. What? What the hell?
It is time I told you the story of my people. It is time you learned the truth about this world.
Okay.
The Dalmar was a great, noble, and prosperous civilization. They were people of peace. A thriving society of wisdom and art. Then, everything changed. At the dawn of the Third Age, we were attacked by the Shadows. Over the years, our colonies have fallen one by one. The Shadows have slaughtered our settlers without mercy. They filled our hearts with terrible fear. In the great halls of Unnatko, the capital city of our world, the Circle of Elders have chosen three of our best people. Roran, the most skilled warrior. Theodore, the brightest of all scholars. And a devoted shaman, me. We were called the Amajat, the Seekers. Our goal was to find a legendary place of great power, Quernalok.
Oh.
We embarked on a journey to face the unknown. And to find what was hidden. This quest has forged a strong friendship between the three of us. Over the years, we visited countless worlds. We became exhausted and shattered under the weight of the responsibility. We learned that the Shadows had reached the outer walls of Unnatko. We almost lost faith, but we couldn't stop. As we kept searching, we found a world that astonished all of us. This very world. Here, we found what we needed the most. Time. Time to find a way. A way to save our people. Our worries trapped us here, knowing that our home is only safe if we stay on this island. The search was over. We knew that finding this island in our time of need was not an accident. It gave us hope, and we started to believe that this world was Quernalok. Over centuries, we perfected our expertise. We, the Amajat, have become idols of strength, intellect, and discipline. But it was not enough. The infinite time we have been given made us obsessed with the overcoming urge to save our people. As we kept training and learning, pursuing power slowly became our only passion.
I see.
We had risen above the boundaries of the body and mind. Eventually, we almost forgot the very principle of our mission. And then, I had a vision of our people. I saw their suffering. At that moment, I understand we had become the very power we were sent to search for. It was time for us to head home. I knew we were prepared. We were ready to face them. But the shadows were no longer my worst fear. I was afraid of what we had become. I was afraid of facing reality. We appeared at the edge of doom. Most of our great city was burning in flames. Unatko, our home, was about to fall. And then, we vanquished our enemies. There was no fight. They couldn't fight back. We cleansed our city of the shadows. A war that had lasted years ended in seconds. We were the saviors. We were celebrated like gods. And that's exactly how we felt.
But mad with power.
The people we saved were not really our people anymore. We no longer belonged here. We felt we were more. After witnessing our power, people lost their faith in the council. We, the Amajat, have taken their place. But having fulfilled our destiny, the strong bond between the three of us started to fade. A new era has begun. The era of division and conflict. As our disagreements became stronger, we turned against each other.
Oh, there we go.
This caused the people to take sides. A war has erupted from within. A war we were too proud to stop. Chaos rumbled across the streets of Unatko. We watched our once thriving society fall apart. Our home was destroyed. All because of us. Because of what we have become. I couldn't live with myself. I couldn't bear the great emptiness I felt anymore. I left what remained of my world for one final journey. Following the path we once walked upon, I found Quernanok once again. But I did not come back for its power. I came back to face the curse that made me forget who I was. I spent centuries meditating on my past mistakes, trying to find a way to make up for what I'd done. By accepting the loss of all attachments that kept me in the physical world, I managed to ascend to a new form of existence. In this way, I will never lose myself again, and I can guard this place for eternity.
So the professor was sorta right. You destroyed...
He didn't want you to know about our heritage.
Her own people.
He didn't want you to see how the power of the island can ruin an entire civilization. He too wants to ignore it. But you must know the truth. He cannot accept the destructive power of this knowledge that he worships above all else. No civilization could contain this kind of power.
True.
Especially not a single
person. I really understand it now.
It is time for you to return to his path. I will meet you back at the entrance.
Okay. So yeah, the professor was right. That's true. That they destroyed their own home. But he did not tell us the complete truth that it was all just because of, yeah, they get mad with power. So yeah. They turned onto each other because they felt like, yeah. So I am literally now on her side. Because, yeah. It's true that the power the professor seeks is actually, like, it's dangerous. It's really dangerous.
Now you must continue following his guidance. I will help you get back on his path. He was the first person who found this island after we left. And you must be the last person to ever be here.
Don't be worried. Really, do not worry. Yeah. So really, no one should wield, like, infinite power, pretty much. First, I thought it's just about energy source at the beginning, but apparently it's, well, because of, like, power, like, power. Like, being the mightiest and that stuff. Now. Sure.
But soon, we will meet again.
Yeah. Alright. Right tunnel. Oh, I see. I need to put the green one here. Glad that I took it with me back. And... okay. Pew! Let's go. Again, going to take it with me. Lower mechanics. Numbers. Reset, start, something, something, and ABC. No idea. At least not now. He's playing with a rainbow. Okay. Can I pick something from here? Nope, I'm going to read his letter just in a bit. Okay, let's read it right away.
These are the lower levels of the mechanics. It was here I learned that all the attributes of the different minerals could be harnessed by dividing the energy beam of the white crystal. The shortage of crystalline materials no longer hindered my work. With this knowledge, I was even able to isolate green crystal beams. The exact same energy ray that the ancient gateways use. This could suggest that there is a connection between this world and the origin of the ancient gateways. Focusing on my work helped me deal with the unbearable loneliness that started to consume my mind.
And here it comes, he was getting madder and madder. Truth conquers all. So, let's go upstairs. Alright, so I cannot go through this door. That's good to know. Let's check the upstairs over here. So I guess we will need to open this somehow. And... okay. And we have some combination lock. Cool. So there is nothing, like, no hints anywhere, as far as I can see. So... I have no idea. Looks like I am not supposed to do anything with this. Oh, did the door upstairs open with this? No. Okay. So I really don't know what am I doing here. Oh, I see. So this actually just indicates where the stuff is, probably. So I assume that we need to like build this, right? Probably. Oh, I see. So now I move the orange one, which was, well, the one down here, upstairs. So I'm going to move the white one to B. And I will move the orange one on top of it. No. So can I move it to C actually? And in the meantime, while it is moving, let's get in here. Because I want to see what's inside here. Hold on a second, is this? Wow. So, is that the top room with the telescope? Like, what? Did I really just brought in the telescope room? Open that door. Okay, and I got a piece of some wheel. All right. So let's check it now upstairs when I can go upstairs. So can't do anything here. But okay. Oh, I see. So we will need to put in all the different pieces. Got it. Maybe now I need to move the lower platform to there. Let's give it a try then. So we have the B over here, so I'm going to move, well, the white one on the top bottom. So let's move it all the way up. And I will move the orange one down. And then the white one back to C. Also, no idea what is this exactly. So I'm just going to ignore it for now. So now I'm here. Come on. Let's press this. And let's take it. So that's another piece into here. We are just missing one more. Missing the one more, one last. Which I assume is going to be inside there? So we need to do something with that? Like this? Oh. Wow, okay. I assume that this is going to be a little bit harder than I thought. So, just to give an example, put all of these in, hit start, and it will just rotate the things. And if I will press reset, it will reset to its original position. Okay. So is there something that moves only one? No. Okay. So basically, yeah, it's simple, but it will take some time. So let's go first over here, right? So if I will do for this one, honestly, what I just did, like, randomly, is I put all the exits over there. Which is something that I don't really want. I want them all in here, but... okay. So, it's like, yeah, you just put the numbers once and it will just rotate, so we don't really need to care about that. Alright. So, let's see how long this will take me. Holy crap. So the middle ring I would like to not move, really. Because it is at the correct position. So the middle ring is controlled by this one and this one. So it goes minus 3 and plus 2. So it goes minus 1, so it moves over here. Right. So I don't want to move it at all. So I will go 1 and minus 1. So it will basically move 1 more and 1 back up. Well, 1 back. Now for these two, I'm just going to care about this one, so I need to move it here. So it needs to be minus 2. So minus 2, it will go here. So let's go actually minus 3. Plus 2. Wow, I did it! The first time! Wow! Goodness gracious, it's awesome. Alright, so what do we have anything here? What is this? It's the good old room, but I have like nothing to do in here. Yeah, this is, yeah. But this looks new. Where did I got this key? Oh, it was from the diving room. I see. Alright. So now I will need to go to the other side. Which means I need to open up the number 2. Which is on the top. So let's hit reset. And let's do it once more. And maybe minus 2 here. Yes, finally. Holy crap. I don't know why the bottom one was easier and the top one wasn't. All right, but I think this way in is barged, so I need to move the room to up, like to the sea. So I need to move the white one all the way up to to A. And then I will move the B, sorry, the orange one to C. Can't move it at the same time. Sucks. There we go. So let's go up. And here we are. Last piece of wheel. Put it in. What? Like, what the hell? Slot machine? What? Is there anything I can, like, do? Honestly? Like, you are going to let me play slot machine in here? Oh, there we go. Time to crack the safe. Let's get this. And let's get the safe. Holy shit. He gone mad, really. It's just, it's fairly obvious with this one. Alright, so safe. 46-11. So 46. Eleven. Oops. Okay, I need to go the other way. 11. 37. 35, 36, 37. And 77. 77. Yep. Oh! Oh! Nice, nice, quick way back. Awesome. Like it. Alright, so I guess we are going back to the middle.